This is how to play 10 Years Gone by Led Zeppelin on a four-string guitar. Three strings wouldn't be enough here for the way that I've worked out how to play it anyway. So normally you would have, well, one of the standard tunings for a cigar box guitar would be open G tuning. So this guitar was in open G tuning. So I've still got the second string, which is a D, and third string, which is a G, and then fourth string, which is a B. But what I've done here to be able to play this is tune the lowest G down to D. So it's an octave lower than the D above it. So it's this. So in comparison to the higher D. So you've got D, then D, then G, then B. So the opening riff is like a standard A, so you've got your fingers on the second fret of the higher D string, the G and the B on the second fret. So you play that, then you take your third finger off the second of B. Then you play the second on the G, and then play the B open. So it goes. Then it moves to this chord, which is your first finger, second fret of the G, and your second finger on the third fret of the higher D, and your third finger on the third fret of the B. So it's, let it ring like that. So you go. Then when you've let that ring out, you do this. You've got to get the timing right with the records. It's a bit funny sometimes. So it goes. So you sort of go up and down the strings, you go from the higher D and play the strings of that chord up like this. Oops. So go up and then down, so you're playing the D, the G, the B, and then back to the G, and then the D. And then play an A again. So. Of that all the way through, so you just try and listen to the record and try and keep the timing with it. I think the timing is slightly different each time, so it's. So once you've played a few of those. The next riff. So you play an A, you go. Then the next chord is first finger, first fret of the higher D, and your third finger on the second fret of the G, and your second finger on the first fret of the B. So you go from the A to that. Is up here on the ninth, so you've got second finger, ninth of D, third finger, ninth of G, and first finger, eighth of B. So far. Then you've got this shape here on the seventh, so second finger, seventh fret of D, first finger, sixth fret of G, and third finger 7th fret of the B. And then move that down to. So the whole thing. Goes and what you know you're reduced to with the four strings and stuff, so it's a little lead into the next riff. So it goes from second to third, then it goes, got to go up quickly, so it's second, third, then it's 7-9, and that's on the low D, so, and then it's second, third on the higher D, and then back to the second. So you start with your first finger, you're only just playing the two middle strings here, so first finger on the second fret of both strings, so play it once, and then play it again, but hammer on to the fourth fret of the G with your third finger, and then pull off again, so go. First finger, 4th fret of G, 2nd finger, 5th fret of the high D, and then it's the same pattern again as the first part, and you hammer on to the 6th fret of the G and then off again with your 3rd finger. You just do, you don't hammer off, so it's... finger on the second fret of the G and your third finger on the fourth fret of the D. So the whole thing to that jump. Shape and then hammer on with your pinky to the 4th fret of the G and then back. And then from there, take your 3rd finger off and put your 2nd finger on the 3rd fret of the D and play, keep your finger, 1st finger on the 2nd fret of G. Play those and do a hammer on with your 3rd finger to the 4th fret of G and then off again. So the whole thing. And then you go back to 2nd fret of both strings. To go back to that those parts will keep repeating through the song. There's about three other parts to the song. There's a couple of parts under solos that you can play along to. The first solo starts here, where you've got your first finger on the fourth fret of G, second finger on the fifth fret of the D, and your third finger on the fifth fret of the B. And then you do a slide up two frets, so you go. So it always starts like that. Then slide that back down. And then you do first finger on the third fret of B, second finger on the fourth fret of G, and third finger on the fifth fret of the D. So it's like this. Then add your pinky to the fifth on the B. Strings, and your third finger on the fourth fret of the D, and then go to an A. So the whole thing. Second time, it's the same again at the start. And then I just move at the end of that part, I just go, so you've got first finger, fourth fret of the G, and your first and your third finger on the fifth fret of the D and the B rather, and then slide them up to. This little heavy riff, you can either play on both D strings or just the low D string. In either case, you play once on the fifth fret, then you play twice on seventh, ninth, and seventh, and then three times on the fifth. Thank you. fourth fret of the highest D string, first finger on the second fret of the G string, and play the rest open. So it goes. Your second and third fingers are on the sixth fret of the D and the G, and your first fingers on the fifth fret of the high B. Up to this chord, which is your first finger on 10th of B, second finger on 11th on the G, and your third finger on the 12th on the D. So from the start. Those are all the parts. parts to the song, you mostly play that part again for the outro, but there's another part where it does that thing again. So you just have to listen to the record, get to know it, and if you can put all those pieces together, you've got the song, and on four strings rather than six. Cheers.